Hello, hi everybody. I am Thekla Petridou, a Cypriot psychologist, YouTuber, and an author, and this is our weekly video in English. Today it's Friday, the 28th of August 2020, and the subject is interesting. Is it wise to start a relationship with a married person? Is this a wise choice for you? Either you are a man or a woman. Either you are straight or gay, and you are single, and you are longing for love, sexual pleasure, and companionship. And you get offers by people who are not single like you, that they might be married. This is a very common situation nowadays. Our society is much more prone to infidelity than maybe 50 or 60 years ago. I'm not a sociologist, so I cannot analyze why, but my opinion as a social scientist, even though psychologists view society from a very different angle than sociologists, my opinion is that we haven't been able to adapt to new ways of thinking and new ways of freedom, adapting to a society of information, and that gives a lot of possibilities through the internet, through the social media, through technology for people to move into directions that they wouldn't be able to move before without getting noticed. Today's technology allows people to communicate with other people than their spouses, and it's easier to form an extramarital affair. Not that in the past extramarital affairs were not happening. Of course they were happening. I remember when I first started working as a psychologist in Cyprus in 1998, circa 1998, that most of my cases of couple therapy and family therapy consistent of one of a case of infidelity. So my video today is about you, that you are single, that you are not married, that you do not cohabit with anybody, that you are 20 years old, 25 years old, 30 years old, 35 years old, 40 years old, in whatever age, and you want to experience companionship and love and romance, and your offers are those of married people. Is it wise for you to go and start an affair or a relationship with a married person? Some days ago, I received an email from a very young male. I think his age was 29 years old, in which he wrote that last year, a lady from his environment, from his social environment, approached him and initiated flirting with him in order to have an extramarital affair. She's married. She's something like 16 years older than him. She's married. She says she's happily married with children. But she told him that her marriage was lacking of passion, lacking of excitement. So she chose this young man in order to educate him, that's what she said to him, educate him in sexual relationships, and she put her own terms from the beginning, that this is not an emotional relationship, we will meet for having fun, we will not reveal the relationship to anybody, I'm not willing to divorce my husband, my main goal is to have quality sexual relationship with you. And after 1 year of meeting with that woman once or twice a month and communicating with her via texts and phones, and today's technology allows us to do that very discreetly. You could use a fake account on the social media, and you can use a messenger, you use whatever means that they cannot be tracked down, and you can communicate by text messages or video calls or whatever at your own convenience. And your husband or your wife, your parents in this example, because I think this guy resides with his parents, do not get notified that you're doing something that is maybe not socially acceptable. His idea was that I am young, I have more needs, I have more sexual needs than meeting once or twice a month. And I told that to my partner, but she says she has her children, she has young children, she has family responsibilities, and she cannot meet with me more often. But, he said, when she wants to have sex with me, she is insatiable, unstoppable. She tries and she makes it happen. But she doesn't care about my own needs. And he was asking for my opinion on how to proceed. The first question I posed to him was, what are your feelings towards Zuma? Are you in love with her? He said, yes, I think I'm a bit in love with her, but I think she has a much bigger crush on me than I have on her. And I had to explain to him that having a crush is not the same as being in love, or having sexual needs is not the same as being in a romantic involvement with somebody else. All people can distinguish between sex and romantic love. And it's easier for somebody to distinguish plain sex from romantic love if they are already in a romantic relationship. This woman that initiated the extramarital affair with this youngster, she's already married, she's already in a romantic relationship with her husband, she has her own family, she has her kids, and the only problem she said that she has with her husband is lack of passion, not lack of emotions, not lack of connection. So it's easier for her to divide the two and say, with my husband I have romantic love, I have family, I have other kind of feelings, and with my lover I have only passion and excitement. It's not very easy to distinguish between the two if you are single. If you are single and you do not have any other romantic interests, and you start a sexual only relationship with somebody who is married, it's much easier for you to get carried away from your feelings and fall in love with somebody who is not falling in love with you. I'm sure that this lady is not in love with this young man. Why? Why can I be so sure? Because as a psychologist that I have worked with literally thousands of couples, that most of them were going through rough patches like infidelity and stuff, I've seen this. I've seen this in my clinical practice, that if someone is in love, I mean, if they are fully committed emotionally to a relationship which is not only sexual but is also romantic for them, they would do anything to overcome the obstacles to meet the person that they are in love with. These ladies, way that she divides her married life from her sexual life shows that she's not in love with this guy. Because when you fall in love, then your brain is not thinking right. Your brain gets affected by the hormones or neurotransmitters of oxytocin, which is the most common known neurotransmitter that is related to love and bonding. And you feel pumped and you feel boosted and you feel that you can do anything, even getting divorced from your husband and living your life with your lover. This boy asked me, because we had an exchange of emails and also made this video in Greek, asked me, is there a way other to be with her unless she divorces her husband and she has a normal relationship with me? He noted that, I know what you're going to tell me. You're going to tell me that she should finish her marriage and continue with me. I wouldn't tell him this. I wouldn't tell him this, that this lady should finish her marriage, get separated from her husband and continue with him, because there is a very important element missing. She's not fully committed to him. She chose him. She chose him as a sexual object. I'm sorry to say this. The same thing happens in respective cases of older men or maybe at the same age with their new partner, of men that they are married, they have their married life going on, and they choose to separate sex from love, and they choose to have extramarital relationships. Most married men that have extramarital relationships, they say that it is for fun. I do this because it's normal for a man to change sexual partners. I do this because all my friends do this. I do this because it's a norm of the society. It's an unspoken norm of the society that you can live your life in pieces and in boxes. You have small boxes in your brain. This is love, this is family, this is sex, this is excitement, this is fun. And that it's not easy to combine all together. I mean, to have one partner that is also, that you are also in love with, that you can have a very deep bond and communication with, that you can have fun with the same partner, you can have excitement with the same partner, you can make great sex with the same partner. No, you cannot have this. This is a social stereotype that most of us have in our brain through our pop culture and the way we're brought up and through stories we hear from people around us and through our experiences, the experience of our parents' marriage or other other family members' marriage, and we see that people live their life in boxes. They do not achieve so easily. It's a very rare phenomenon in today's society to find a couple that they can combine all aspects of bonding together, that they have a loving bond, a romantic bond, an emotional bond, a sexual bond, a fun bond. This is not unachievable. I strongly believe that if people put this goal, set this goal in their life, that when I will settle down, and if I settle down, if I get married, when I get married, if I get married, I will get married to somebody that completes me in all aspects of what I want from life. If they do this, they will not need to separate themselves in boxes or in cells. But society pushes people to get married. You're 30 years old, you should get married. You are 25 years old. They might say to a woman, you're 25 years old. You haven't had a boyfriend. You haven't had a relationship. When are you gonna get married? When are you gonna have children? Don't be so selective. Our purpose in life is to get married and have children and serve society. So most of us, we get pushed without even realizing it. We get pressured by our parents, our social environment, by society in general, to proceed to getting married with somebody that we are not totally compatible with. And in love relationships and in marriages, you need to have the highest compatibility possible. Even though there is this idea that opposites attract each other and same things, they do not attract each other, in human relationships and in marriages and love relationships is exactly the opposite. The more similar two people are, the more enduring and deep their love connection is. So, going back to the original question, is it wise to start a relationship with a married person? No, it is not. It's not wise. Because a person who is already married have their lives in boxes. They have already ticked yes to the box romantic love. They have already ticked yes to the box marriage. They have already ticked yes to the box children. So their boxes that they need to be checked is having fun, having sex. So if you proceed into starting a relationship with a married man, it means that you put yourself in a position where you will not be fully loved. You will not experience the whole range of emotions of romantic love. You will be limited to having fun and having sex. And it is very, very common for a single person to start a relationship with a married person, and in the procession, as the time goes by, the single person falls madly in love with the married person, and the married person feels that he or she are pressurized by their lover. They don't feel well because they do not want to end their marriages. They do not want to ruin, in brackets, their families. So these relationships come to, very, very often they do come to an end. And not the marriage is the one that ends first. The extramarital relationships do. I've seen many cases where a single person might have started an extramarital relationship with a married person, that the married person was in a place in their place in their life that they wanted to divorce. They might have divorced while having the extramarital relationship, but soon after the divorce, they also finished the extramarital relationship because that original extramarital relationship served one purpose: to help them deal with their marriage or their marriage's problem, or to help them deal with the divorce. So when the divorce proceedings finish, when everything comes back to normality, they might realize that their new lover is not who they wanted, is not the person that they really want in their life. Maybe that partner gets connected with the negative experience of their previous marriage. I mean, if you start a relationship and you have 1 year extramarital relationship with somebody, while at the same time you live in your marriage, even though you think you can put your life in boxes, the one box affects the other. So in your brain, you connect your lover with your wife or with your husband. So when you finish with your wife or your husband, maybe there is maybe there is a desire in you which is not conscious, subconscious desire to finish also the new affair so that nothing reminds you of your past. Of course, there are exceptions, but the exceptions are there to emphasize on the rule. The rule that if you go into a relationship with a married person, it is as if you decide to go into to a turbulent sea without a lifesaver. What are the exceptions? The exceptions might be those of people who have known each other for a long time and they have had a way of communicating with each other or bonding with each other in other levels. For example, some people might be lifelong friends for many years, and they might start having a relationship when the marriage of the one person is coming to an end. But their own relationship has not started totally at that time. I mean, if you knew somebody from before, if somebody was part of your life, maybe not as a romantic partner, in other ways, and you have a true knowledge of this person, and romantic emotions start to appear at a period of time that the marriage is going to an end, if you do that, if you proceed to have the extramarital affair, and very early on you discontinue the marriage, there is some case that this relationship might have some viability. But it's better to stay on the safe side. It's better to avoid getting into this kind of trouble, because the majority of married people who create extramarital relationships, they do so in order to have some fun, to forget their problems, to put variety in their life, and not because they are available and ready to be loved and love another person. I will close this video in English with a quote I said in a Greek video, and one of my viewers sent me an email and she said that this quote has helped her to overcome difficulties and take difficult decisions. I really do hope that your life is surrounded with people that deserve your love and they love you the way you deserve. All of us deserve to be loved wholly, properly. I give you my love. Have a nice weekend, everybody. See you next week here. Bye. And if you liked my video, please press the like button and share with your friends. Bye.